That expressed wish of good luck from George Preston, the ring announcer, is the sentiment shared by most of these fans in the Sportatorium tonight. They're pulling for Ricky Starr to defeat Duke Kiyomuka. This was to have been a Texas heavyweight championship match. But instead, Duke Kiyomuka no longer holds that championship, not at this time. So the title is not at stake tonight. Duke Kiyomuka and Ricky Starr are slated for the best 2 out of 3 falls, an overall 90-minute time limit. And all of this conversation has to do with Kiyomuka's desire to prevent his being counted out while one or both of his legs would be outside the ring. There have been times when Kiyomuka felt that he was unjustly robbed of matches by some officials, especially referee Leo Voss, because he claims Voss didn't notice one of Kiyomuka's legs was outside the rope. These two have quite a score to settle. Starr is bridging, coming up for a headstand if he can get momentum. At least he does a reverse somersault. He's being held down by a double wrist lock. Starr has countered the hold. He's actually applied one of his own, but it didn't stick. Kiyomuka comes up with a key lock. Referee's warning Kiyomuka to be sure that his knee didn't come across Starr's throat. This is a crisscross head scissor, one that you very seldom see because few wrestlers have the leg control to apply it and make it stick. Despite the fact that Ricky Starr is the man with the most powerful hold, it's he who was in danger of being pinned. Ricky Starr, as an undergraduate, was a wrestling star at Purdue. He's lightning fast in all of his actions. He stays in perfect physical condition. Kiyomuka was pulling on Starr's trunks that time. The fans on the near side of the ring attracted the referee's attention. Our Texas wrestling main event between Duke Kiyomuka and Ricky Starr is for the best 2 out of 3 falls or a 90-minute time limit. Mr. Kiyomuka has come out of that crisscross head scissor, and he himself now has a double leg lock on Ricky Starr. To break this double leg lock, the way Ricky Starr is trying to do it, took tremendous courage, because when he was pushing that hole backward to gain the initial advantage, the pain must have been terrific. And then at the moment he threw Kiyomuka off balance, he ran out of the hole. Judo chop delivered by Kiyomuka before the hold had been completely broken. That's the reason for this warning from referee Leo Voss. That's Ricky Starr down on floor level outside the ring. Slung there between the top middle strand by Kiyomuka. Starr has a count of 20 to return to action when he's down on floor level. A wrestler on the canvas, either inside the ring or on the apron of the ring, just outside the ropes, has a count only of 10. Duke Kiyomuka, with his background of judo, jiu-jitsu, and sumo wrestling, and his knowledge of catch-as-catch-can, American wrestling holds, is a hard man to beat, because when he starts using those judo chops, as he is now, combined with the other holds which he knows, it's difficult to counter. Minutes have gone by in this first fall of our best 2 out of 3 fall main event tonight between Duke Kiyomuka and Ricky Starr. And as you can tell from the reaction of the crowd, they're pulling for Starr. Of course, Ricky is one of their prime favorites, but by the same token, they don't care who defeats Duke Kiyomuka. Kiyomuka, you've been caught pulling hair. Kiyomuka's using a double wrist lock on Ricky Starr. You notice those elaborate shoes which Ricky sports. They're a combination of black and white leather at the top of each shoe. Ricky Starr, because of his very fine amateur background in wrestling, is one of the finest defensive wrestlers to be found anywhere today. It takes a real master to put a hold on him that is good enough to pin him. Of course, he falls victim sometimes to roughhouse tactics. But That's probably because of his shortage of experience, comparatively speaking. As far as a double wrist lock or a top press holding him down, it's not usual that a wrestler is able to pin a fall on him that way. An arm drag, which has been turned now into an arm breaker. Yamuka's pulling on the back of Star Skunks. Now pulling his hair. These judo chops across the throat, of course, are illegal. They're supposed to be either across the chin or across the upper section of the chest. That's like an Indian's war whoop. Mr. Kimuka better watch out now. Kiyomuka is far from out. As long as he can still reach for an opponent, as long as he can still land a judo chop, the opponent is in danger. Kiyomuka's in position now for the application of that Japanese sleep hold, which he likes to use. This is the Super Duper A number one special treatment. This is the hardest kind of sleep hold to get out of. Referee's checking for muscular control and reaction, and as long as Ricky Starr is able to move his arms, as long as he has muscular reaction, the fall will not be stopped. But when he's no longer able to hold his arms up or to control his actions, then the referee will immediately stop the fall. He figures it's time enough. Duke Kiyomuka has won the first fall. Kiyomuka is the victor in our first fall as he wins with a Japanese sleep hold over Ricky Starr. That's the first section of our best 2 out of 3 fall main event tonight. Referee's warning Kiyomuka away before he can harm Ricky Starr further. It's probable that Starr will be back and ready for action for that second fall. This is wrestling, and the second fall of our best 2 out of 3 fall main event tonight, Duke Kiyomuka and Ricky Starr are at it once more. You know, Duke Kiyomuka won that first fall in 9 minutes and 55 seconds with his Japanese sleep hold. And as we forecast, Ricky Starr came out of it very quickly, as most of the victims of that sleep hold do. We've had a number of fans ask the principle on which that Japanese sleep hold works. Actually, it stops the flow of blood to the brain, produces momentary unconsciousness. It's not a dangerous hold unless it should be applied for too long a period. That's why the referees use extreme caution in checking for the muscular reaction in the hold. Just the very moment a wrestler begins to show that he's no longer able to exert muscular control, they stop that match or that fall. And so it was that Ricky Starr lost that first fall to Duke Kiyomuka with the Japanese sleeper. Duke Kiyomuka outweighs Ricky Starr by a margin of 13 pounds in this match tonight. Now, would you say that that number 13 will be an unlucky advantage for Kiyomuka? Or do you figure that it will play any part in the outcome? I'll tell you what I think. I think probably the speed and ability and conditioning of these wrestlers is going to have more to do with the outcome of the match than that 13-pound weight advantage which Kiyomuka carries. You can always depend on these two to be in top shape. Ricky Starr has been an athlete most of his life. And in recent years, in fact, since World War II, Duke Kiyomuka has wrestled regularly. And so he too has stayed in top physical condition. Duke Kiyomuka was being asked by the referee if he would give up the second fall. Of course, you could tell almost without waiting what Kiyomuka's answer would be. He's not the kind of a wrestler to give up a fall except as a very last resort. Kiyomuka was able to break that up as he pulled on Starr's trunks. Well, he didn't break it up all the way, did he? The more pressure he puts on this reverse chin lock, the tighter Starr pulls that leg lock. Starr's hands gave way. These judo chops are under the throat. That's the reason for the warning from the referee. Kiyomuka into the ropes. And he's caught with a hard flying drop kick and a second one that pivoted him around and a third one that knocked him down and a fourth one to go with it. A fifth in a row. And now a top body press. The count of one, two, three. And Ricky Starr is the winner of the second fall. And now the falls are all even at one each as Ricky Starr wins the second 7:10. Welcome back to the Sport Farm in Dallas for the third fall of our best 2 out of 3 fall main event. Kiyomuka and Ricky Starr. Kiyomuka has climbed back in the ring rather slowly. He's off to a fast start though in this third fall. He's taken the offensive early. He apparently is determined not to let this young upstart, Ricky Starr, get the jump on him in the third fall. Ricky really got the jump on him and gave him 5 drop kicks in a row to win that second fall in 7:10. Our Texas wrestling main event tonight is for the best 2 out of 3 falls and overall 90-minute time limit. These two main eventers tonight are among the top-notch wrestling performers in the entire country. Week in and week out, you'll see the very best here at the Sportatorium in Dallas. These Southwestern wrestling fans like the going hot and heavy, rough and fast. And if a man can't take it as well as dish it out, he doesn't stay in Texas mat circles very long. Texas wrestling, the purses are good. The rules are not enforced too closely. And for that reason, the very finest performers in the country are attracted to Texas. Now, exactly how does young Ricky Starr figure to counter this arm strangle? With a pivot. Kiyomuka is attempting to grapevine Ricky Starr's left arm in the ropes. This is the third and deciding fall between these two main eventers. Kiyomuka's strategy apparently calls for weakening that left arm and shoulder. He's been working on Starr's left arm almost since this third fall began. Every one of these 7,000 fans here at the Sportatorium tonight is trying to quarterback Ricky Starr into a victory over Duke Kiyomuka. They're shouting encouragement and directions from the stands. Every man figures that he knows just the way in which Starr should be able to beat Kiyomuka. A lot of wrestlers have tried to figure that out. And some of them have been able to do it, but they've been few and rather far between. Kiyomuka, with his unusual combination of judo wrestling and American Catch-as-Catch-Can is hard to beat. Kiyomuka, like his Japanese ancestors of many generations ago, wrestles barefoot. And that has its disadvantages, as you can see. Just as Ricky Starr seemed to find the bout going his way, Duke Kiyomuka. Oh! Kiyomuka missed that flying tackle that time. He had intended to drive Starr back against the turnbuckles, but instead he rams the top of his head into that steel turnbuckle that fastened the second rope to the corner ring post. And now, that body flip. Another double flying mare. And a top press. One, two, three, and Ricky Starr is the winner. Ricky Starr is the victor, winning the second and third falls from Duke Kiyomuka. You remember that Kiyomuka won the first fall, and Starr, in 7 minutes and 10 seconds, came back to take the second fall. And now he has won the third fall. Promoter Ed McLemore and I certainly hope you've enjoyed it.